Buenas noches. Bienvenidos a este evento que es muy, muy importante para el Instituto Cervantes y también para la Universidad de Leeds. Don't worry, I want to speak in Spanish all the time because I know some of you don't speak yet in Spanish. I am Pedro Eusebi, the director of the Instituto Cervantes, and I said that this is a very special event for both institutions, for Instituto Cervantes Leeds, and also for the university. Because this year we are celebrating 30 years of Instituto Cervantes in Leeds. It was actually the first institute that was inaugurated in Great Britain before London or Manchester, the three places where Instituto Cervantes is. So the very first was Instituto Cervantes Leeds, and we are very grateful to the university for welcoming us for those fruitful 30 years. And in this special occasion, we could celebrate no better than with Zarzuela. Zarzuela, that you might know, is a typical Spanish genre which started in the 17th century, and it takes the name from the place where the court and the artists met outside Madrid, La Zarzuela, which is the Palace La Zarzuela. Today is the residence of the King of Spain, and it takes the name also the zarzas. Zarzas are so small plants from the meseta in Spain, and from the Palace de la Zarzuela, it took the name where these artists singers met, and Calderón de la Barca was one of the first, the great Calderón de la Barca, one of the first composers or librettos for Zarzuela. After the 18th century, with the arrival of the Bourbons, the royal family of Spain nowadays, some of them, they don't speak Spanish, spoke the Spanish at the time, and they were very committed with opera from Italy. So it was a certain decline for the Zarzuela, but again in the 19th century, it was retaken because it was very popular, not only for the elites, for the cultivated people, but also for the general public. Actually, most of the things that are deal about Zarzuela are the everyday lives with a lot of jokes, a lot of a lot of things about the ordinary people. So that made appeal not only for the people who liked the opera or the music in a more traditional or elitist way, but also for the general public. And also, it explains something special about Zarzuela, because we have what is named the Género Chico, the small Zarzuela. It was an evolution. Zarzuelas at the beginning was like even 4 hours long. Today, tonight, it won't be 4 hours long. But there was La Gran Zarzuela, and then the Género Chico was an evolution, because with the economic crisis in the 19th century, the artists could not, they wanted to bring as many people as possible, but with a repertoire of 4 hours was too expensive. So they reduced the time, and it was like an hour concert, and it was named the Género Chico. So we had the Gran Zarzuela from the Baroque period, and then Género Chico, which is most common nowadays. In the 20th century, again, the Zarzuela became very popular. We have also the Teatro de la Zarzuela in Madrid, and it also was brought to was Spain at the moment, in the colonies, especially in Cuba, was nowadays it's still very popular, the Zarzuela, and even in Philippines, where it was mixed with the local culture, and it's a very unique creation. Tonight, we will have the mezzo-soprano and the pianist, Silvia Lucas and Sophie Clarke. Sophie Clarke, she's a mezzo-soprano, but she's also an actress and dancer from Liverpool, who was has been awarded the Hargreaves and Ball Scholarship to study the Masters of Music in Classical Singing and Opera at the Royal Northern College of Music, under the tutelage of Yvonne, Howard and Louise. Among Her performances, highlights in recent years, include alto soloist in Handel's Messia at Nottingham's Albert Hall, and the mezzo-soprano soloist in the latest London performance of Ben State's Mass and the Royal Festival Hall. Shortly before this, Sophie filmed her solo performance for the BBC One's television series All Together Now, sharing classical music with a wider audience. Silvia Lucas is a Spanish pianist and performer educated up to a PhD level at the Royal Northern College of Music in Manchester, where she was highly commended as a pianist in the Gold Medal Weekend in 2015. Ever since, she has been a very active performer of new music. As a contemporary pianist, Silvia has premiered a large number of piano works, most of them dedicated to her. This includes the 3 piano concertos and over 20 solo works. She has even given solo recitals in the United States, Cornell University in New York, Spain, United Kingdom, Germany, and many other places. So thank you very much again for being with us tonight. Thank you again to the University of Leeds for those 30 years for being with us, to our green head of the studies of the Spanish and Latin American studies, and please welcome with a great applause to Sophie and Silvia. Thank you. Only one important thing, we will have 20 minutes interval, okay?
Good evening everyone, buenas noches. How are we all? Are we all well? I'm Sophie and this is Silvia, and we're absolutely delighted to be performing an evening of Zarzuela and Spanish music for you. So, we're going to begin in 1894 with a piece from La Verbena de la Paloma, or The Fair of the Virgin of La Paloma. The first piece we're going to perform from this Zarzuela is Un Manton di la Cina, which speaks about wearing your finest clothes and your most expensive shawl or scarf to celebrate this very special festival.
Oh,
piece to get us started. We're now going to move to 1927, and this is Romanza del Palau, From Lost to Aragon, or The People of Aragon. It takes place in Zaragoza during the 1920s. Gloria, the heroine, has left the town and her fiancé suddenly to become a variety star. Many years later, she returns, very successful. However, she's met with lots of hostility. Hearing the church bells, she sings of her childhood and her beloved homeland.
Oh,
siete canciones populares españolas, or seven Spanish folk songs. It's a 1914 set of traditional Spanish songs for voice and piano, or guitar, by composer Manuel de Falla. In addition to being Falla's most arranged composition and one of his most popular, it is one of the most frequently performed sets of Spanish language art songs. The styles and provenance of each song are quite different, as they're from different parts of Spain, but all of the texts deal with love and the courting process, whether playfully, seriously, or tragically.
Thank you.
thank you. We'd like to finish the first half with a fun little number. This is from La Tempranica. It's a Zarzuela in one act and can be considered quite a short and simple work. However, the number La Tarantula in Bisho Mumalo stands out, and it's become one of the favourite pieces to be performed. Now, anyone who knows this piece will know that there are a lot of words and it is very quick, and I am not Spanish, even though I wish I was. So this is La Tarantula. Please wish me luck.
Sister Sadie never harmed.
Did you all have a nice interval? A nice little relax? Very good. So we'd like to begin with Act 2 with a story of a streetwise menagilda or maidservant. This is Tango de la Menagilda from La Gran Via. This Zarzuela pokes fun at the police, the authorities, and urban politics. The performers impersonate local streets, buildings, and other typical characters, such as this streetwise maidservant. She makes her way to the top in a very unusual way, by stealing.
Thank you.
in that number, she's describing all of her best moves for stealing and how to make your way to the top. We'd like to perform another piece from La Verbena de la Paloma, Solea. This comes from scene 2 of the Zarzuela and takes place on a street in the Barrio de la Latina, which is a historic neighborhood in the central district of downtown Madrid. A crowd have gathered around to hear a flamenco singer perform En Chiclana Mi Crié, which translates to I grew up in Chiclana.
Thank you.
stand closer and closer to the piano, we'll be able to get past it next time. So this next piece, I think, has one of the most beautiful melodies. This is Ballada y Alborada, written in 1898, which is exactly 100 years before I was born in 1998. The plot of this one-act domestic drama centres on Manuel, a young Madrid bookkeeper who loves his master's young new wife. But the daughter of the house, Trini, is in love with him herself. The climax of the story comes when Manuel leaves the establishment for good, and Trini, the character who sings this piece, sings a touching alborada, a dawn serenade, which mirrors her own unhappiness.
Thank you.
that's just such a lovely melody. Now this next piece is Marinella, Marinella. It's from La Canción del Olvido, and it's a one-act zarzuela with a romantic drama, and it's set during the Napoli, I can't even say this word, I don't know why I put it in the script, because I can't say it. It's set in the Kingdom of Naples. That's the best way for me to say it. So the heroine, Rosina, is first heard off stage singing her melancholy ballad, The Song of Forgetting, which gives the work its title. And it's normally to a delicate accompaniment of a harp, but unfortunately, Sylvia's car's a little bit small for us to fit a harp in, and we didn't really want to strap it to the roof on the motorway, did we? So you'll have to do with piano for today. So this is Marinella, Marinella.
Triste cantinella.
España venga. It's a true canción española in which the main character sings how proud she is to be from Spain. And tonight, although I'm not Spanish myself, I have been very honored to sing such beautiful Spanish music and to work and perform with the wonderful Silvia Lucas. Can we just give her a little bit of applause? Thank you very much to the Instituto Cervantes in Manchester and Leeds, to the University of Leeds, and to you, our lovely audience, for coming to our concert. We hope you have enjoyed this evening of Zarzuela. Zarzuela, sorry, I'm still working on that.
Thank you.
Singing with me. We're going to do La Tarantula one more time.